So, what are we talking about next?
Well, let's just get to the main course.
The goodies?
The meat and potatoes?
Yeah, the potatoes and the meat. End of the month, which means it's time for our game of the month. Has everybody played Zelda Breath of the Wild?
Not a little bit.
Yeah,
JK.
A little bit.
I know, you played a little bit, Pete.
Yeah,
but I think
shame.
You formed enough to get an opinion.
Oh, yeah, I don't need to play a game for 20 hours to know whether or not I like a game.
Yeah.
So, let's wrap about this for a bit.
Okay.
Pete has said he doesn't want to rate it because he hasn't played it enough in a prior discussion.
It wouldn't be fair.
I don't want to rate it because I haven't beaten it yet either. Are you going to rate it, Jeff?
I would like to rate it given I've dumped 45 hours into it.
All right. Let's go
That's a pretty substantial amount, enough to warrant a score, for definitely.
That's 45 hours is more than I've played most any game in the last several years.
Destiny.
I probably dumped 45 hours into
it. You probably dumped much more than that.
How can I find out? Probably bungie.net or something.
Yeah. Wait, there's got to be a bet.
Oh! I bet you have played Destiny more than 45 hours.
No, fuck
yes.
That.
You cannot get out of this with your legalese bullshit.
I'm not accepting that bet. If you want to, if we can do a closer, who's closer, I'll take that bet.
No. I don't like that.
All right.
I want to tie this one up as a win under old Berardini's book.
Yeah, no.
I've done it twice now. I'm
because
not
I don't disagree that I've played it more than 45 hours.
Hold up. Let me get my phone out. You can keep talking.
Hey, wait, is the bet in place?
No.
I got to figure out how I win legally.
You,
I'm just going to direct message Diego.
You got to go an over under. It's like over under 200 hours.
Whoa, that's way too high. Let's do 60 hours.
Okay.
I'm saying you're definitely over 60 hours.
So then I would take over too, so it's not a good over under.
No, you have to take under because I chose over. All right, fuck you. We'll figure this out. I'm going to get you, though.
I'm going to get you.
What are your stats? You said you're at 45 hours?
Yes. Pete, what do you have your hours?
I'm still at around 10 to 12.
Oh, my God. Deb just sent me, like, basically a pornographic image of my daughter.
That's not even true. She's just being cute.
It
is just
a
weirdo. She's
here,
biting
here. There, Pete. Finger. Can you see that?
Yeah.
That's cute.
How cute.
Aw.
I'll throw that in the video, but that's just weird.
It's cute. It's super cute.
All right, enough.
Although, I should preface by saying that this month was a tough month for me.
Yeah.
I started a second job, and I'm teaching. So, I'm getting towards the end of the semester, so I've been straight out. So, not only I haven't had much time to game, and it was PAX, so it's been crazy for me.
Hey, you're a busy bee, man. We get it.
So I apologize, gentlemen, for not playing it more.
Wait, did you say your hours?
There's Jeff and his classic listening.
I said I'm like 10 or 12 hours in.
Well, it says on your stupid...
I didn't check.
All right. You can check, though, can't you?
I don't have my Switch. You have yours, though.
All right.
Get your stuff out. All right, I'll just go because I know that I'm beyond the both of you, but not the furthest along in our group that is playing it. Anyway, I've played around 55 hours. It doesn't seem to be ticking up. I feel like I should be at 65 or something, but it says 55 hours. I have 13 hearts. I have 2 stamina wheels. I've done...
2 full stamina wheels?
2 full stamina
Jesus
wheels.
Jesus Christ.
I have done... Completed 61 shrines.
Jesus.
I've found 70 Koroks.
All right.
And I've got 2 divine beasts down.
Okay.
And I have the Master Sword. What?
All right, I'm at 11 hearts. I got a stamina, will, and 2/3.
Sure.
Looks like I've done 40 shrines. See, I don't know about the Korok seeds, that thing right there, because that says how many I have, not how many I've spent.
No, that's your total.
Okay, I'll say then 32. That's definitely not the total number of orbs.
No.
Spirit orbs.
Orbs equal how many shrines you've done. You've spent 36 shrines, and right, you have that's very four smart. Orbs left.
Right.
So, I know... So this game has been a very unique experience for all of us, I'd say. Maybe less so with Pete, because you're... Is everyone playing it at work with you, Pete? Do you talk
I work to in my basement, man. I don't have anybody next to me.
Oh, yeah, I know. anyway.
I would assume people remotely have got to be playing. I don't know if you guys talk about that in your meetings, but...
No, not really.
Yeah. That's sad. I feel like that has been a crucial part of our experience, and going along with that has been, like, talking to people, but not talking directly about it, and because you don't want to spoil things, and everyone's really hesitant to have stuff spoiled for them.
Oh, yeah, we should say we're going to try to keep this spoiler-free.
Yeah, so we're going to do our best to not dive into specifics like that, because I wouldn't want to listen to it either. We get it. We get it. Okay?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
And that, so, for me...
So shut up, motherfucker.
The most enjoyable part is that thing where it's like... You want to hint at is like, have you gone to
have you
the
been
Northeast?
To the East?
Yeah. Did you go all the way? And it's like, wait, no. It's like, okay, never mind. We won't talk about it. No. But you try to hint at enough to where then finally somebody... does know what you're talking about. You're like, yeah, so did you? Oh, and then you get to talk about
it. I did. Yeah. I did go to the Northeast. Yeah.
Hey, well.
I imagine that would have made it a much, much different experience for me, just having that interaction.
Well, because it felt like the original Zelda in that, like, you would go to the playground and talk about which bush to burn, and did you do this, and did you know you can get 100 rupees if you just go here, or this is where the sixth labyrinth is. Like, it's so fun learning all that.
Yeah.
Going off this topic, we have a lot of viewer reactions to this game, because surprise, surprise, everyone in the fucking world is playing this. But on Twitter, @JohnPV says, it's the first game in decades that has me thinking about it all the time when I'm not playing it. I feel like a kid in grade school playing the original game, imagining what could be behind the next corner or what secret is hidden in a part of the map I just found.
Yep.
Yeah, it's exactly what it's been like. Trevor Young says, I know there's a lot to be said about spoilers, story, environmental, and items, but some of the most fun I've had with this game is in discussing secret things others have found or techniques of going about doing things. It totally reminds me of the first Zelda where there was no guide. You're just dropped in and told to go explore. I found out about which wall to bomb for a secret room, not from my own exploring, but from hearing about it at school. I don't know how this team got people talking about this stuff again instead of just looking up a strategy guide. I know it's out there, but I don't want to go look stuff up.
That's
I want
totally
to talk
true.
Respectfully, avoiding people's topics that they want to avoid. Yeah, and I think about this game nonstop, and I want to look at all the articles that are online, but I don't because I don't want it to be spoiled for myself.
That's right. Yeah, like, I know you have the Master Sword, and I know all it would take is a quick Google search, and I could find out where to get it and how to get it and how many hearts or whatever I need to unlock it. I don't want to know.
No.
Like, I find little clues in the game that tells me it's somewhere, and I'll go get it when it's time.
And it's so cool when you actually come across it. It's like, I found it. I've only heard about it. Trevor continues. I mean, just today, I shared my strategy for getting fish, bombs, and someone gave me their method, shock arrows. Neither of us would have ever tried that on our own, and by our excitement of discovery, we both gained something by talking about it. And that's awesome. Thank you, Trevor. We agree. I feel like that's been one of the best parts about the game, is the communal experience of indirectly speaking about it to others.
I haven't tried either one of those techniques with getting fish.
No, I don't really care about fish enough to get them.
My precious shock arrows, I wouldn't want to waste them on fish.
Like, oh, really? I'm, like, stocked full of shock arrows right now, so when I'm out of normal arrows, I'll just use shock arrows. I have so many.
You're like, man, you want a few?
You find them or buy them?
No, I've found them. There's like a side quest thing where they need you to get some, and then you...
Right.
Actually, well, whatever. No spoilers, everybody. But then I just plundered the fuck out of that area for...
I know what you're talking about. Yeah.
So let's break it down like we normally do, minus scores, except for Jeff. So, graphics, what do y'all think?
Oh, graphics, Pete, you can, come on, dude, you can at least jump in on a couple of
no,
stuff.
No, I
like
can
that.
Jump on the graphics for sure, and I can jump on a lot of different things, but it's very pinpointed.
All right, I gave the graphics a 4. So, all right, well, let me go over the rating system again. It's 1 through 5, 1 being terrible, 2 being rough but not a disaster, 3 acceptable but not noteworthy, 4 noticeably great, 5 stands as best amongst its contemporaries. So I gave the graphics a 4, being that I think it's noticeably great. I like the cartoon shading of it. Much more than I thought I would. It just feels good. Like I just enjoyed it. It separated it as its own unique game. I felt like I originally, when I saw the trailers, I thought I was gonna miss the idea of it being really like a tangible real world.
Yeah.
But now playing it, I'm so glad they didn't do that.
Like the type of graphics that everyone apparently wanted after Ocarina of Time for years and years and years, like the super realistic Zelda, and nobody ever got it. It's like, you don't actually want that. That would look weird.
Yeah. Well, because I always wanted, like, you know, all the visual development work, like how awesome that, like if you go to the main title screen, that artwork.
Yeah.
I wanted a game that looked like that.
Hmm.
And so far we've never got it, but this is very acceptable for me. Yep. But I knocked it because there's some noticeably glaring issues with, like, rocks and cliffs, and it's just like, Jesus Christ, what is this, Nintendo 64? What the fuck with these polygons?
Yeah, when I first started, I was coming right off of just a small foray into Horizon, and that shit is amazing looking, and then you jump into this, and it's like, that hill is literally just Geo with a texture on it. There's no grass. There's fucking nothing.
There's not even like a bump map or nothing. It's just like, wow, this looks bad.
But I think to its credit, and maybe on purpose, maybe not, but like when it's scaled down on a small screen, if it was super busy and complicated, it would be harder to see. When it's cleaner and simpler, like it is, it's a quicker, easier read on a tiny tablet.
Man, that goes... I mean, it's not fair to say it's the game's credit, but just the fact that Zelda is so portable certainly adds to it.
Yeah, and I was surprised when I plugged it in the TV for the first time how good it actually looked on the big screen. I thought it would just look like a portable version of it, but it's like, it looks fucking nice because of the design of it, basically, not because of graphics or fidelity or anything.
Yeah.
There was definitely somebody behind that idea. So it was, for me, I thought the graphics were great, and it was a good choice to keep it within that Zelda realm. So honestly, I really enjoy the look of it. I think it's fantastic.
Yeah, I think it's also worth mentioning that it is supposedly the biggest open world game to like ever potentially be released, and you know, on a console that seems to be inferior to PS4 and Xbox One, it's still damn impressive.
Well, yeah, and then the fact that you can just keep running and running and running, and there's not like, all right, let me load this zone.
Yeah,
no, you just keep going.
Yeah,
and then you get onto a tall tower and you can see forever. And you literally get to, like, all right, you use your little scope, and you're like, all right, I'm going to go over here. I'm going to lay down some markers. That way from up here, I know where I'm going.
Yep.
God, that's awesome.
I do wish the draw distance was a little better. So, yeah. Because like, you get a certain distance from, like, an enemy camp or whatever, and it's like, I'm that pretty sucks. Sure enemies will be there, but I can't see them yet because they haven't spawned.
Yes, that definitely sucks. I've thought camps were empty and come rolling up. And it's like, oh, fuck. Should have turned on my gear.
Speaking of wide, vast open world games, our friend Hector wrote into us and is comparing Zelda to The Witcher 3. If you didn't know, Hector is the most humble guy in the world. He starts with, IMHO, H is for Hector. This is the best game to date by far. He's also Spanish, so bear with me. Nothing comes close to it in terms of playability. For example, last game I've been playing is The Witcher 3. I did not finish it, but was thinking maybe going back to it after the Zelda and a couple little indie games I have on my queue. However, after playing Breath of the Wild, I find it impossible. The game feels empty in possibilities, repetitive on its mechanics. I feel it has nothing but story, 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 and more story.
Meaning Witcher 3.
Yes. I feel I'm doing too much of the same, which is the opposite of this new Zelda, where every step is about doing something new. Hope this marks a new breakthrough in video games industry and lots of developers understand the concept of variety regarding game mechanics, situations, etc. Sincerely yours, Link. P.S. I hate Epona and the green classic costume that only comes through amiibos.
Hmm.
Did you hear about that bullshit?
I didn't until I read that review. I didn't realize that was part of it. That is lame.
There's a lot of cool stuff that is literally only through amiibos, and amiibos are apparently impossible to get. The Zelda amiibos.
Hmm. All the Zelda ones?
Pretty much. If you have any Zelda amiibos, Pete, then they'll...
Yeah, I got three of them.
Which ones do you have?
I have the original, like, Twilight Princess sort of Zelda.
Oh, fuck.
And then I have the Toon Zelda.
Oh, fuck.
And then I have the 8-bit Zelda.
Oh, fuck, Pete, you got all the good ones.
You gotta put that shit in there.
Dude, you snap them on and you get, like, exclusive shit that you can't get unless you own those.
See, I didn't know that. Alright.
I don't even know where you put the amiibos on the thing. I don't know either.
Like, nothing in the loading screens told me about the amiibos or anything. Is that just...
I think if you press start, right?
I have no idea.
Yeah.
Like, even the me creation is just buried in menus.
Shit. Well, because isn't there like an amiibo reader in the Switch? Like in the...
Yeah, it's on the Switch. I just don't know like where.
Yeah, I don't know where either. Is there like a little box or something? Because on the Wii U, there was like a little box kind of icon.
Well, there's the share button that's a little box. I feel like I've seen in videos you put the amiibo on the lower left corner of the Switch. I don't know though.
Shoot. Oh, yeah, here, look. Amiibo. Don't use Amiibo or use it.
Oh, there you go.
In your options. This game is compatible with Amiibo. Would you like to enable Amiibo functionality? Use Amiibo. You can now use Amiibo. With the...
Go fuck yourself.
You can't find an Amiibo.
Yeah, I don't
this
have
This is useless to you.
Anyways, yeah, you should try that, Pete.
Yeah, I will.
Sort of going off of what Hector was talking about, and if you talk to him, won't shut up about, is how sort of revolutionary this Zelda is, just on all of the potential possibilities and how they've set up all the gameplay. So I think it's worth mentioning that the ability to literally climb any surface in the entire fucking game is really, really, really cool. Really awesome and probably really hard to design a game
around.
And
when they first said that, it's like, if you can see a mountain, you can get to it. I was like, yeah, but there's not going to be anything worth it. At a certain distance, you're going to get the feeling that there's nothing there.
Yeah.
There's something everywhere.
Yep. Every mountain I've ever climbed, there's always been a little something there waiting for me.
Yeah.
Every mountain I've climbed, I've run into a guardian and he's kicked my asshole.
Well, yeah. For a while, when you see a guardian, all you gotta do is just run the fuck away. But then... Spoilers.
Yeah.
More graphic stuff. Have you guys experienced any slowdown?
That part sucks.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Why? 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 I mean, is that... Are they left over trying to get nostalgic with the original Nintendo?
Too many sprites. Ah!
Yeah.
Like, I thought it was, because I first experienced it when it was in the TV mode, whatever it's called, and I was like, shit, and now that it's rendering at, like, 1080p instead of 720, in this like heavily wooded area and it's raining and I'm fighting 10 different enemies. It's, you know, it's just the circumstances, but I've run into it on portable mode, whatever, just in a heavily wooded area.
I see it a lot when it's like, when there's a lot of grass.
Yep.
It just slows down.
There was one moment I was on a mountain and I was like attacking a moblin or something. And like, since it was a steep hill, the physics took over when I hit him and he just kept sliding. But like, it was obviously really hard to calculate and the game froze for a good 15 seconds.
Whoa.
And it just stuck on one frame and I was like, oh God, what do I do? So that sucked.
That must have been kind of scary, actually, having a new system do that on you.
Yeah. Wasn't great. But, you know, everything caught up.
Well, the one thing about this game is, like, maybe it's different if you get more hearts or whatever you're doing, but I feel like every goblin and moblin or whatever can do serious fucking damage to you.
Yeah. Ooh. That reminds me of a good user comment. Hold up.
Like, I feel like in any other Zelda, you get even 5 hearts and you get an upgraded weapon and you can dominate any enemy you've met at the beginning of the game. These guys all do serious damage. If you get hit by their sword, it's like, hey, there goes 6 hearts.
Yep. Okay, so this is from our friend Benjamin Gross, and he says, hold on. So far, Breath of the Wild has been a journey of equal parts wonder, surprise, satisfaction, and frustration. I feel like the, quote, allow the player to do whatever they want, whenever they want, unquote, end quote, is both its most shining feature as well as the most frustrating. Please understand that the following review is based on having only played through about 10 shrines, so I think he's in a similar stage as you, Pete. I absolutely love that the game seems to be built on the concept of if the player thinks such and such should work a certain way, then it should actually work that way. It's immensely satisfying to overcome obstacles in the world without the game outright telling you to do so. Arrows can cut ropes, torches can light wooden barriers on fire, knocking trees releases their apples. At the same time, though, because the game never tells me exactly where I should and shouldn't be, I constantly feel like I'm encountering content that's outside my current power ranges. My measly 4 hearts can be extinguished in one hit by almost any foe outside of the tutorial stages, and seeing the game over screen so frequently is painful. I have no doubt that these pains are a result of the fact that I'm still very early on in progression and perhaps coming into the game with some skewed expectations, and I can't wait to continue playing. In the end, Breath of the Wild is a brilliantly made, enormous game that maybe just harkens back to a time when games weren't supposed to be press A to win. So, yeah. I do think a lot of your issues, Ben, are because it's early in the game, and I definitely died a shit ton at the beginning, too. And I remember seeing articles that was comparing Zelda to, like, Dark Souls and Bloodborne and all these, like, you know, everyone considers to be difficult games. And I was like, Zelda? What, are you fucking kidding me? And then you spend the first couple hours with it, and you get your ass handed to you every time you run into an enemy. But eventually, you know, the more time you spend with the game, and depending on how you play it, I guess, you can level yourself up pretty damn quickly, run across some really good weapons, and hold your own pretty easily.
I will say, like, I think last episode we talked about how I don't like playing stealthy games.
Yep.
I probably play more stealthy in this game than I've played any other game. Like, I, for the most part, very, 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 very rarely go hand-to-hand combat with anybody.
Really?
Yeah, almost never.
I barely ever play stealthy in this game.
Oh, really? I feel like I always try to get high ground and just bomb them.
Okay, bombing is not stealthy.
Yeah, but they don't know you are. You throw it, and they don't know where it's coming from.
Yeah, I mean, I've definitely done that, too.
So I'd say that's
I found myself playing that way, too, like, only with arrows, you know.
Yeah, like, arrows and bombs are the majority of the way I kill people.
Yeah.
Because I will say the mechanic of using your shield and dodging,
it's not great.
It's bizarre. I had a very hard time trying to figure all that out.
And even then, it's a little rough to know the control. Like, you have to hold down basically 3 buttons in a very specific way. It's difficult.
Yeah, and I have been playing combat pretty much all the way through. I feel like it's stuck in its old Z targeting ways. Like Ocarina of Time created the whole Z targeting thing, and I feel like the industry has moved past that, but Zelda still clings to it. But I also can't imagine how other games are handling it. Like I feel like Zelda combat has always been its own fucking thing, far and away from every other game.
What about the way like Batman games handle combat?
Yeah, see,
would that not work?
I don't really remember how that like locks on to other enemies though.
I mean, I feel like it's just like one guy at a time attacks you, so you kind of get the opportunity to like.
Yeah, and I think the way that goes is you hold the direction or the stick towards which guy you want to attack or something.
Yeah.
But it always snaps to all the characters. I don't know, it's weird.
Well, and then I really liked the mechanics. Did you ever play Kingdom Hearts?
Yeah, actually they just re-released the HD remaster.
I really like that combat. Like it's a full world just like Zelda, but you feel so powerful as Sora flying around using your ki and just destroying everybody, and the combos you do feels like really fun.
Yeah.
It's too bad. I kind of wish it was a lot more like that.
Also, I don't know if it's the animations or if I'm just not picking up on it, but I feel like most video games, I'm very good at picking up the cues of when I should dodge, because all the enemies do like the nice antic. I can never get the timing right against any enemy on this game.
Same thing. I mean, that's a good segue into the controls part. I don't know what you guys rated it, but
didn't.
Given how much we're complaining, I should probably lower it. But I rated it actually a 4, saying it was really good. But I'm talking much more like about the controls of like, I never felt outside of the combat, like always running, jumping, the horse riding, the interacting with the environment inside the shrines. I feel like always was very natural. Picking up objects was really good. I do still have some other complaints about my number one complaint is when you get a new item in a treasure chest, it doesn't immediately give you the option to swap it out with something.
Yep. I can't count how many times I've reopened a chest because I had to drop another item.
How did that not come up in playtesting?
Because they're the Japanese are very good inventory managers.
I'm sure there are ways in the game that I have not found to increase your maximum inventory size.
Wait, you haven't?
I think once.
Oh.
So I think I have 8 weapons I can hold, and it's fucking frustrating.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm at 15.
Jesus Christ.
That's actually one of the reasons why I don't really like the game.
Just the inventory management?
Well, there's more to it than that. I don't think it's a bad game. It's just not a game that I want to play, I found.
Going off of controls, our buddy Raymond says, Zelda Breath of the Wild is, in my opinion, the best in the series. I feel like I can play this game forever trying to complete all the side quests. My only gripe with the game is that the controls took a little time to get used to, and the Switch's buttons are labeled differently from Xbox.
Yeah, that is for fucking sure. I don't know how many times it said hit Y and I kept hitting X.
Yep. Every time you want to pick something up, you accidentally drop it or whatever.
Yeah.
It's so hard just going back and forth between like my PlayStation and the Switch.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Yeah, going between the 3 consoles must be a fucking chore.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Jeff, you have all 3, right?
I do, but something as stupid as going back to my Xbox, which I have hooked up to my cable, and it's like certain buttons to like go into the guide channels and like literally switch the channel. I'm now hitting the wrong fucking button just to go into the guide.
Yep.
Like basic stuff. And then Switch messes you.
Just to finish Ray's message, load times on Zelda could be better, but worth the wait. I love the mechanics, and I'm ashamed to say I enjoy cooking too. 2 thumbs up.
Yeah.
I fucking love the cooking.
The cooking. It reminds me so much of fishing in Ocarina of Time.
Yep.
I would just go to the pond and try to, like, hook the biggest fish. And now I just like to cook different meals.
Look at Pete's face. I can already tell he hates the cooking.
No, it's not that I hate the cooking. It's that the game is getting so much credit for its cooking when it's been done before in Monster Hunter many times over.
True.
But the difference between Monster Hunter and Zelda that I've found in the cooking is that Monster Hunter lets you know when you've made something and remembers it. So you can go back to it and be like, hey, you know what? I can make that again. That's cool.
I will say I wish there was a recipe book or a cookbook that kept track of your success.
That seems like a major oversight.
Yeah. It's frustrating. But if you do, it's a dumb workaround, but if you do make a really good meal, you can right-click on it, and when you hold or drop or whatever, there's the recipe that tells you
how you just can't eat it and have that one be the last one.
Right, you just gotta use your fucking brain and remember.
Do you think there actually it was a legitimate choice?
That's a lot of shit to remember.
That's what I'm saying. I'm wondering if it goes back to the days where we used to write shit down.
Right.
Video games.
It very well could be.
I genuinely have notes written in my phone about the game. Not recipes, though. I'm not going to waste time with that. Because, like, if you just know the general rule of cooking, I don't think you need to even remember recipes. Like, every food item says, basically, if it has boosting effects, and if you just mix it with something that replenishes hearts, like a radish or meat or whatever, then you're automatically going to get something good, regardless.
But there's extra special stuff that I wish I would have more time to experiment with, like baking pies and risotto and all that kind of stuff.
Yeah. I've still yet to figure out how to make a stew. I've got milk and I've got eggs and I've got meat and it seems like everything I need, but whatever.
I've made some pretty fun stuff. Yeah.
I've always ended up in the realm of the
dubious food.
Dubious food.
Arcane food.
I'm just happy that shit doesn't poison you. It still gives you like a half a heart. It
still gives you something. It's like a hash.
It's like Nintendo.
I will say, there has been times where I feel like this should make a really good meal, and it turns into dubious food, and it fucking pisses me off.
Yeah. But you know what's great? Is when you're cooking something, and it's got the usual like... But when the music comes up and you know you've got something, like, oh, I can't wait to see what I'm making.
Do you always listen to the whole thing or do you skip?
You can skip it.
You just hit X.
Oh, I did not know that.
Monster Hunter again.
No. All right, Pete.
Yeah, but Monster Hunter is not fun, Pete. you're forgetting
distinction. I've had the completely opposite experience.
You prefer Monster Hunter to this Zelda?
I prefer the certain aspects of this of Monster Hunter.
Pete is a hipster.
Wow.
I am not a hipster in the least bit. You know that.
He wants to play this shit on a cartridge.
I am not a hipster. I was there. That's the difference.
That's you were the first one playing.
That's not a hipster thing to say at all.
What do you guys think about the motion controls?
Oh, I had to turn it off. I hate it.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I didn't like it.
I didn't experience the motion controls.
So basically, if you, especially like targeting with your arrows, your whole switch becomes the way you can target.
Oh, I never really messed with that.
I actually...
Maybe I glanced over it or something.
I find it useful. For specific occasions, it also frustrates me a lot, too.
Have you guys actually found that the precision on the thumbstick is not very precise on the Switch?
Yeah.
Like, if you wanted to go by, like, a teeny tiny increment, you can be like...
Oh.
I'm showing Michael, but...
Nope. I can't hear you. There you go.
So if you, like, barely move, like, if you move your joystick, like, a couple millimeters, it doesn't do anything. Really? And then you get over a little bit, and then it starts flying away. Like... The precision of like the Nintendo 64 was way better than these stupid Joy-Cons.
Hmm. It's interesting. I haven't noticed it, but I'm also compensating with the motion controls.
Does the motion controls work with the scope?
Yeah.
Oh, see, maybe I got to turn it back on because I find I'm trying to aim at a tower to mark it that's way in the distance, and the precision of the thumbstick won't get it there.
Oh, that's frustrating.
Yeah, so I'm like, I go back, forth, back, I miss it. Oh, fuck, nope, back, forth, back, forth. And then I get so frustrated that I just go back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, hoping that at one time the pixel will hit it.
Yeah, maybe turn it back on, you know.
yeah.
I remember our buddy Brandon was playing it, and he didn't really realize that there was motion controls, so he just like every time he pulled out the scope, he just thought there was like built-in camera wobble to it. So he was so frustrated by it.
I will admit that's how my first experience was with the shooting the bow and arrow. I was like, why is it fucking, God, why?
Yeah.
It was so difficult. And now,
you know what I always run into with the bow and arrow? Is I always end up throwing my fucking sword.
Oh, yep. I definitely did that the first like 3-4 days I played the game. I'd be like, all right, let me get this out. Oh, there goes my sword.
I've been playing the game for a very long time. Probably last week, I just completely forgot that functionality even existed, that you could throw your sword. And I was just like pressing the button, and I didn't have a weapon equipped at that time. But so I just was pressing. I was like, what does this button do? And he just kept bringing his arm up to his back and nothing was happening. I was like, what is this mechanic?
Oh, man, my favorite weapons are the boomerangs.
I don't like the boomerangs.
What?
Maybe I'm not hitting a button, but every time they come back to me, he doesn't catch it.
Yeah, you just hit A.
Oh. I just expect him to catch it.
Oh, no, you have to hit it at the exact right time.
My boomerang that I ran into was actually I actually used it as a melee weapon, and it worked really well.
Yeah, that's how I've been using them. I never throw my boomerangs.
In the description, it specifically says not recommended as a melee weapon.
Well, I don't read all of the descriptions.
But yeah, you target just like a bow and arrow. That's shoot why they don't last it, and it like long. Does massive damage at a distance.
How far do they go? Like, can you? How do you aim it?
It goes into the same, like, reticle type thing.
But does it go straight to where your reticle is, and then it curves back? There's not, like, an arc out to the right in a big circle? It's more of, like, a backwards D?
I don't think it has as much distance as an arrow, but it goes pretty far. It goes to where you want it, and then it curves.
Okay. All right. All out. What do you guys think of all the Sheikah slate tools? The magic. The magic stuff. I don't know if it's magic. Probably more technology.
The magic versus tech. I think it's tech. Or it's supposed to be anyway.
I'm talking about like bombs, magnesis, stasis.
I would have rather had actual bombs.
Myself. Whoa, really?
Oh, no.
When you explore more, Pete, you're going to fucking love the fact that you have replenishable bombs.
The number one thing I thought was a great choice was not having to constantly replenish bombs, because it's a saving grace when you're trying to be stealthy and fight, and it's a farming tool at a certain point. So, I don't know. I thought it was a great choice not to make it so you had to buy bombs.
Yeah, I love it. I wish somehow I had magic arrows that were automatically replenishable.
Yeah.
Actually, going back to those amiibo things, I think one of the amiibos gives you a special bow that has infinite arrows.
Oh, really?
And it's like, fuck you, amiibo.
Yeah, dude, this is that's like pay to win sort of shit.
These are like the rumors that would happen on the playground back in the day. If you have this, you get unlimited arrows.
Do you remember the rumor, not to digress too much, but the rumor of if you, like, there was this rumor going around about if you found this secret room, they gave you a number and you got a free copy of Zelda 2.
I did hear that, yes.
Yeah, yes. So I was bombing everything.
Yeah.
It's just ridiculous, but yeah, that's cool.
I still remember my dad doing the second mission on Zelda, you know, if like once you beat it, you get to play it again.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever it's called. I'm sure it has a name, like level 2 or whatever it is.
The second quest.
Second quest, there you go. He graphed out the entire overworld and then bombed or flamed every single thing in the entire game.
God damn.
Wow.
But then at the end, you have an entire...
Did he have a blue or a red candle?
Well, I mean, eventually he got the red. I mean, to do that as a blue. But he did a fair share with a blue candle as well, yeah.
That's crazy, because you got to leave... For those who don't know, you have to leave the screen after you use the blue candle once and then go back if you want to use it again on the same
thing. Yeah, so he... And then he pushed every rock from every different direction. But at the end, you had this huge graph paper
our grid paper, whatever, of the entire overworld for the second quest, all yeah, mapped out. So you just look at that, and you'd be like, you could play any time. Be like, all right, 100 rupees here, 15 rupees there. All right, this shop has the shield for 60 rupees. This is where you get the arrow. It was fucking awesome.
Similarly,
that's why I love the... sorry, Michael.
Sorry.
That's why I love the homebrews that come out for the NES. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So, like, Zelda Outlands, and there's, like, another one where you play as a wolf, and there's another one where you could play as Princess Zelda herself.
Yeah.
It's just kind of like that same exact experience, just again.
Zelda Outlands was so good.
You know, yeah. Mindy got me, I think it was Outlands, like a homebrew thing on an actual cartridge so I could play it on the Retron. Never worked.
Yeah, you didn't get Outlands. It was a...
Did you upgrade
But it was a Link to the Past type thing. It was a Super Nintendo.
It was
a,
yeah.
Yeah.
So it's not Outlands, I guess.
Did you upgrade your Retron firmware?
Yeah, he did, because he brought it over to my place, too, and it wouldn't work on mine either.
Do those work on original Super Nintendos, too?
I don't know.
Because I tried it on that one, but I didn't know if it would actually work or not.
It should.
Yeah, I think it should.
Yeah, that's what I figured.
Because all of my homebrews and whatnot work on the regular Nintendos. So
yeah, seems like it would more likely work on it than it would the Retron. Anyways.
So talking a little bit about the item management and everything that we were talking about earlier. How do you feel about the weapon's breakability, durability? Stuff.
I can see that it'd be frustrating for other people. I personally enjoyed it. Like, I think that's very, I don't know. I can see that being very opinionated type of thing. Take it or leave it.
Yeah.
I didn't like it.
That's my
personal
opinion. I didn't like it at first either, Pete. I sort of grew to like it once I said earlier I didn't want to read articles about stuff. There was one article I read about the weapon breaking stuff. And basically they broke it down like, if you have a really good weapon, don't use it all the time. Save it for specific fights and then just pick up the shitty stuff all the time and use that constantly. And, you know, just always have the other stuff in your back pocket to use it when you need it.
But I do feel like the game rewards you enough with good weapons that you can basically just keep cycling through and using stuff.
Yeah, I think that also comes down to playability, because I know I was one of those people that didn't want to venture very far out. Like, I played in a very specific way. Like, I'd get to one area and I'd scour that entire area, and then I found everything, I'd move to the next one. Whereas other people, I think, were traveling to the edge of the map to get all the towers. And when you get that far out, like, it's commonplace to get really strong weapons. But earlier on, if you don't go out that far out, you're not going to get that good stuff.
I don't know. I don't know how you would start the game going way the far out. You would get your ass kicked. And not to mention, you wouldn't be able to do a ton of stuff because you have no stamina.
Yeah,
that's so true. Like, climbing, you'd have to use constantly stamina meals just to climb shit. So I guess that's crazy that they were able to do that.
Pro tip, though, which I didn't realize for a long time. If you're climbing up a wall, just wait till you get almost done with your stamina. Eat a little thing, and then you get a little bit more. You can just eat a stamina meal while you're climbing or whatever.
Yeah, right.
Took me a long time. I was trying to tame a solid-colored horse, and you need the higher levels of stamina to tame one of those horses. And I was like, I guess I can't do this yet. So I was like, just eat a meal, like, right at the end, and you have more stamina. It's like, oh, sweet, I got me a beautiful horse now.
Yeah, I'm lame. I still haven't got a nice horse.
Ooh, I just found a really good horse last night. She's a beauty. I named her Ghost.
I don't have enough patience to get the good horses.
I think this one's a story horse. No spoilers, everybody. Don't worry.
Oh, no.
Don't worry about it.
I'm lame. I've gotten three horses. I've named them 1, 2, and 3.
Stupid. I mean, it's better than Hector named his horse after his wife.
Oh, he's just riding his wife all the time. He takes her out and puts her back in the barn.
What?
Isn't that the same? It's the same.
Stop it. I don't want to be a part of this. Our friend Louie writes in, I have him noted as breakable weapons, but he says more than just that. He says, holy shit, I don't know if I've been this into a game since Ocarina. It's been years since a game has dominated my thoughts throughout the day like this. Every day. It's all I want to do. I hear you, buddy. Breath of the Wild has somehow found a way to work as a sprawling epic game with way too much to do, in a good way, and also something you can pick up for just a few minutes to get some casual adventuring in between the daily obligations of life, which is made all the sweeter with the Switch's versatility. I sure do feel sorry for any dingus stuck on the Wii U. Hector. Hector doesn't have a Switch. It's just as fun to roam around for a little bit, catching some sweet drifts on your paraglider and technically doing nothing at all, as it is to buckle down for the long haul and get balls deep into that next divine beastly dungeon. Oh, we should talk about divine beasts. Maybe not. I feel like I'm running around in a Miyazaki film, even more so than Ni No Kuni, which I unfortunately didn't get to experience much of, you know, life and shit. It looks great, it sounds great, it plays great, I'm like Tony the fucking Tiger, it's great! If I'm to give one semi-critical comment, I totally get the breakable weapons and being forced to stand on your toes and strategize with whatever tools you have on hand. It also fits themes of loss and longing that are found throughout the entire game. But sometimes I do miss the satisfaction of finding that awesome, that next awesome thing at the end of a dungeon that I can now call my precious and forever feel stronger for it. But you know what? Those bastard geniuses got me to feel that same sense of longing over something that's forever stuck in the past. Good for them. I agree, and I think Louis brings up an interesting point, and also perhaps my biggest gripe about this entire game is dungeons, basically.
The fact there aren't any?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And it's not a spoiler, really. But it's all part of my expectations of what the game was. The shrines are basically one puzzle spread out across a shit ton of shrines.
Yep.
Whereas dungeons used to be one location with a shit ton of puzzles thrown into it. And I expected the divine beasts and all that, all those four things to be the four main dungeons of the game.
Yeah.
But when you get to them, they're not as epic as I had hoped. And they're like sort of
small.
A triple shrine maybe, but nothing as sprawling as any temple or dungeon that previous Zeldas have been.
No. That is a very disappointing part of the game for sure.
Yep.
That's one of the things that's kind of like a staple that comes with Zelda, is that you're expected certain things when you buy something with a Zelda title on it. You know what I mean?
Yep.
If I was to come up and ask you that before this game, what would you say?
Temples and getting a weapon that I use to beat a boss, and then I'd fight Ganon.
Yeah, I mean, right. Zelda to me, yeah, is getting a little bit more powerful with more weapons because you slowly gain pieces of, like, that, actually, fuck that. Alright, I don't know yet, I don't want any spoilers, but where the fuck is the mention of the goddamn Triforce? What the fuck?
Yeah.
What the fuck? I nothing. It, so far, what I've played, they have not said the word Triforce once.
It's your answers and what you're saying now is actually helping me to explain that to me this isn't a Zelda game, which is why I was so disappointed with it.
Huh. Well, I feel like, not that I know, I haven't gotten there yet, but I feel like that will come through the game and through the story and near the ending and
I'm hoping
picking
so
up
too,
memories yeah. and stuff. And like, I know Pete, that they've in interviews and videos, Nintendo released some like behind the scenes making of documentary things about Zelda, and they talk about how they're trying to play with people's expectations of what Zelda games are and what they can keep from previous games and what they can then eject and still feel like a Zelda game and also be modern, you know. And maybe they just removed too much stuff for you.
They removed a lot of stuff. I mean, I saw a Ruby and I about shit my pants.
Yeah, that's true. I didn't see a Ruby for like hours.
Yeah.
That's what I'm talking about. You know what I mean? I was like, whoa, wow, a rupee. And then suddenly I got this, like, remembrance of what I was playing.
Right.
You know? And by no means do I hate... Like, look, I'm not knocking on you guys for liking the game at all. You know what I mean? I think
because you're in the minority.
No, I just think that people, in general, I think that if people... What am I trying to say here? You cut me off, Michael.
Damn. Sorry, buddy.
Basically, what I'm trying to say is that I think in that people should, you know, respect everybody's opinion. I've seen so much hate online towards people who don't like the game, and it's like, it's their opinion. If you like the game, I'm really happy for you that you like the game. Because I wish I had felt the same. You know what I mean?
There's plenty to bitch and moan about, that's for sure.
It's definitely not a 10 out of 10. And it's gotten a lot of perfect scores, and I don't think it's a perfect game.
No, I mean, we've just talked about the controls having issues. Did we? Oh, yeah.
Let's talk about the sound, because I think the sound is the worst fucking part of the game.
Yeah, fair.
Voice acting, awful.
Oh,
yeah.
Oof.
Yeah. Man.
Not even going to get into specific characters, but could you cast maybe a woman that sounds like a woman and not like a child pretending to be... No, a woman pretending to be a child pretending to be a woman.
Jesus Christ.
That's so fucking bad.
There's not a single voice that works. Not one.
Link's voice.
Oh, don't...
Yeah.
Don't ask my wife about that. Like, basically, if she's in the living room, I have to mute the TV. Like, she constantly goes, why does every video game have to have all these just stupid grunting noises? Because here I'm on a raft using my leaf to blow the wind, sure. And all it is for 5 minutes me going, hi, hi, hi,
yeah.
Hi, hi, hi. She's about lost her mind. I was like, I have to get over there. Hold on. Just another, like, couple minutes.
Speaking of annoying repeating noises, how about the shrine notification signal thing?
Oh, yeah.
Shit.
Yeah. That's another thing. If I'm playing and Deb's in the room, I have to turn the shrine signal off.
Yep. I'm sure Mindy doesn't even notice or care. Maybe she does, but she doesn't say anything. But I'm just so acutely aware that she's in the room.
Yeah.
And it will probably annoy her. Yeah.
Deb's never said anything, but I'm like, if I was sitting next to her playing this, I'd be losing my mind.
Yep. So my method, turn it on. If I'm anywhere near a shrine, immediately turn it off. And then just try to find it myself.
Oh, I do the... I feel like... I'm not going to try to one-up you, but I feel like my method is a little better. You just mute the TV, that way you still get the signal.
Ah, that's a good call.
Yeah.
I mean, I flubbed a little bit. I'll at least figure out the direction it is, so I can just walk that way.
Okay. I'll be right back, gents.
You got it.
I will say the music is good. Louis, in his message, mentioned that it reminded him of a Miyazaki movie. I haven't heard the music in the game yet, but the music from, I think, the launch trailer, or, I don't know, probably the most recent-ish trailer. That might be it. But it literally sounds like a song pulled straight from Spirited Away. And then it, like, builds up and is cool. But I think the music, if I'm hoping like the music reaches that level from that trailer and the story stuff later on.
All right. People that don't want a spoiler, 30 seconds. Just give me 30 seconds. I don't think this is a spoiler, but just give me 30 seconds.
Okay.
And you're going to have to listen to it.
Yeah, fuck.
Have you heard tones of the original theme?
Yes.
That is so fucking cool when it happens.
Yeah.
Man.
Yeah, I'm not going to go into it anymore.
Because you're waiting the whole game for it to happen. And then you get just a little hint, and it's like...
A little
you
taste
pee
of
a little
it.
Bit.
Yeah, just a little pee. Just a little pee in the mouth.
All right, spoiler over. Whatever.
Nobody's listening. What else do we have here? How much of your map have you filled in?
I wish there was a reasonable way to find out. I'll show you my map, and then you can tell me.
Well, fuck no, I don't want to know. Just give me, like, a random percentage. I don't want to see your map. I mean...
All right. I'll look. You can tell me. I mean, I will try to guess, because I don't know.
Well, I'm like... So I've been playing the game in a specific way where you start on the Great Plateau or whatever, and then I've been basically moving in a counterclockwise way around Shit. Hyrule Castle. What?
I'm only missing two spots.
Damn, son. I'm glad I didn't look.
I didn't even realize I was that full. Yeah, two spots.
See, I've been taking my time because I just don't want it to be completely revealed. I like having that unknown piece over there. You know what I'm saying? So
you can always go back to it.
Exactly. I always know I have more. But I feel like this game has been completely about discovery, right? That's pretty much what we've been talking about. But like the open worldness of it all, every fucking hill you climb over, there's always something cool to see. Even when there's just like two trees next to each other on a plateau, it's like, I know something's over there and that's going to be cool.
Mm-hmm.
I just love it.
And there's a couple times you'll be playing the game for like, you will have, like, Pete, there's, I'm sure how many hours you've played. There's stuff after 10 hours you will stumble upon and be like, holy fuck, what is that? And it completely changes, like, the way you're playing the game. It's just so fun.
I know. I just, look, I'm not used to the longer games, but.
This is a
I don't feel like I should play a game for 20 hours before I decide whether or not I want to play it anymore.
No, I agree. If you're at 20 hours and you're not liking the discovery part of it, you're just not going to like it. But I just felt like every hour I would stumble upon something new that would make me just excited to continue to find what is around the next corner.
I found the little nut guys.
The yeah. Koroks?
That was cool.
Yeah, there's...
That was good. I found one. I can't find any more of those fucking
things. Oh, Jesus Christ.
At a certain point, you'll start to see, like, patterns. The fabric and the patterns yeah. of how it works. But when you first stumble upon those, like, I relate those to... I'm not going to spoil it, but in The Witness, when you have that, like, aha moment, and it's like, oh my God, I see the world in a different way now. Like, that's what the Koroks were. And then it's also like, there's a lot of Koroks. Do you know how many Koroks are in that game?
I'm sure hundreds.
There's like 99, isn't there?
No, it's times that by 10.
Oh, Jesus. I mean, it doesn't surprise me because I feel like every time I climb to the top of a hill and there's a rock there, it's like, oh, there's a fucking Korok.
Yep. And I lift nearly every rock I find.
Yep. Every time you see an unusual patterned piece of foliage, you're like, all right, there's got to be a Korok here.
Yep. It's just so cool when you stumble upon them for the first time. You can always tell there's something off, and it's like, what can I do here to make this correct?
Yeah.
I'll try this random thing. Oh my God, it worked! How yeah. cool is that?
That's really fun.
Our friend Chris Silver writes in and says, hey fellas, since I spent the least amount of hours out of anyone on this game, I don't really have much to say.
Yeah.
I love you, Chris. The one thing I can say is this has to be hands down one of the best games I've ever played. The graphics are gorgeous, the sound design is beautiful, and the music is amazing. The story so far has me captivated, and the game is fun as hell. My only gripe has to be the controls, but I'm not sure if that has to do with the game or the Joy-Cons themselves. I have to hear what Pete has to say about the Pro Controller before I buy one myself. I'll let you weigh in after this, Pete. When I first started this game, I remembered this quote from Shigeru Miyamoto about his inspiration for creating the original Legend of Zelda. There's a place near Kobe where there's a mountain, and you climb the mountain, and there's a big lake near the top of it. We had gone on this hiking trip and climbed up the mountain, and I was so amazed. It was the first time I had ever experienced hiking up this mountain and seeing this big lake at the top. And I drew on that inspiration when we were working on the Legend of Zelda game, and we were creating this grand outdoor adventure where you go through these narrowed, confined spaces and come upon this great lake. That sense of discovery and wonderment is something he's been striving for in all of his Zelda games, and I feel that Breath of the Wild takes the cake. My in-progress score is 4.9 out of 5, orgasmically good. So that was a cool quote.
Yeah, that is cool.
Thanks for finding that. Pete... You have a Pro Controller? Have you been using it?
To be honest, no. I actually been using I've been taking it with me to bed.
Ah, yeah. So
I pick it up out of its dock and I take it over to bed and I just start playing. I haven't had a chance to play with the Pro Controller yet. Because of an actual issue I found with the Switch, that I had to turn off the auto power or the auto input thing. Because it was fucking with the rest. Can you turn it on? Yeah, you can turn it on and off, I think.
Oh, that's why.
Because I haven't had a problem since once I shut it off. But it was really messing with my channel box. And it was like I'd be playing the PS4 and then suddenly it would switch over to the Switch.
Oh, that's weird.
Yeah, it was weird, so I shut it off. But yeah, so haven't had much of a chance.
I would love to get my hands on the Pro Controller. My hands are literally broken from playing Zelda as much as I have.
It is really hurting my hands.
Like, my hands have already been sort of fucked up just from animating and using a mouse all the time, but, like, there's been a noticeable drop in usability of my appendages since I started playing Zelda.
Yeah, my left thumb is really in a lot of pain.
It went back on sale today. They got it back in stock on Amazon today.
Fuck me. Let me check right now.
Earlier today, I just saw a video, I was on Kotaku and saw it this afternoon sometime.
Well, let me just look it up, because I need that son of a bitch. I've found myself playing on the TV a lot more lately than handheld, just because the variety of ways I can hold it. Like, my go-to is the tube broken apart with the little condom thing added on the side, so I can just, like, lie there however I want with my arms at my side. No, they're not in stock.
That sucks. Sold out quick.
Yeah, I'm sure they did.
Check Kotaku, because they keep it up. They, like, post
when... Oh, they update?
That's how I got it, anyway. The first time was that... I saw a post of it, and I was like, oh, shit, I better get over to there. There it was.
All right, cool.
But I want to... Can I just touch on one thing that bothers me?
Okay.
Is the fact that I can see the parallels between the first Zelda and this one. Like, the whole idea of discovery. I understand that.
Yeah.
But the fact that people are comparing the two is, to me, is puts the first one at a disservice. Because before that, there was nothing like it, ever. Like, there was no such thing as, like, open world or third-person gaming. It was literally the first of its kind. And I guess that is what I was putting the pressure on for this game.
I mean, what would you have done differently to make it the Zelda you would have wanted?
Well, I would have kept the dungeons for sure.
Yeah.
And I would have definitely done more of the heart drops and the rupee drops and stuff like that. Just something good for, you know, beating an enemy and you get something. I found that I always ended up with very little being dropped by the characters that I just defeated.
Except for their teeth. You're an avid collector of teeth now.
Yeah. I have a necklace of horns and teeth going.
I also want to talk about one other thing that bothers me a shit ton about the game.
Yeah.
And I've mentioned it to you, but the crazy misogyny.
Oh, right.
Every town, every girl outside of, like, Zelda almost, every girl is, like, to the beck and call of their husband, or they need a man, or they're too shy to talk to Link. They need to stay inside and work on their risotto. Like, I don't know how many fucking times, but... Every time I go to a new town, there's a new example of some wife being under the thumb of her husband.
Last night, I agree with you, but also last night I came across this lady that she was like, hey, do you want to spend some time with me? And I was like, well, sure I do. And then she attacked me and tried to kill me.
Yeah, that's nice.
But then there's also that lady in... Hateno village, maybe, where she's like, I don't think I should be speaking to you because my husband told me not to speak to men or whatever. It's like, this is weird. And then I just kept talking to her. She's like, didn't I tell you not to speak to me? It was weird.
Once you notice it, it happens over and over and over again.
Also, to be fair, though, I think all the random male NPCs are weird as fuck, too.
They are. They're weird.
It's quirky. Also, did you know Robin Williams is apparently in this game?
No way.
Yeah, you know how he's like a huge fan of Zelda, or was? Like, there's a NPC, I've seen videos of him on YouTube. It looks a lot like Robin Williams with his like squinty eyes and his beard and everything.
Huh. I bet he's dying to play this game.
Oh, oh Shazam.
All right, let me...
Nah, he named his daughter after Zelda, man.
Yeah, and she did some sort of stream, a charity stream. Zelda playing Zelda.
Oh, man. How sick are you of this music?
Which... Oh, the shrine music? Yes. Not that sick, because I'm smart and I'm able to fucking breeze through any shrine I've ever met. Let me end with this final viewer...
Hold on, can we listen to this part real quick?
Okay.
Do you hear in the background like that, like whatever humming sound? Is that like, I always keep hearing it like it's some sort of callback to Ocarina of Time or something. Like it's very reminiscent of older Zelda games.
Which part?
Let me see if I can pump it up a little bit. See if it comes up.
Dead silent.
Hold on. Whoa, that is loud.
Come on.
Copyright strike in 5.
There's no way this could be a copyright strike.
It's
already.
Nintendo, dude.
Already?
Yes.
Well, let's just keep talking through it so it can't.
Doesn't matter. We've gotten so many copyright strikes.
Have we really?
Yeah. That's it just means that they will monetize on the video. It's not like
there, that part.
The like oboe or whatever.
Or like a bagpipe or something.
Yeah. Sure.
Maybe it's not.
I don't know.
It sounds a lot more prominent now that we're listening it here. But like when I'm just playing the game, I just get a hint of it. I'm like, wait.
Maybe?
Is that Ocarina of Time? What is that? I guess not. I'm just reading into things because I wanted it to be true.
Which Zelda did you not play?
Ugh, come on.
You know what I did love about this game?
Tell me, please. A lot
was the fact that you didn't have a character telling you where to go all the time.
Yeah.
That was a breath of fresh air, in my opinion.
A breath of just wild air?
In gaming in general, you know what I mean? It's one of my favorite things about it.
Yeah, It also flustered me a lot at first. So when you have such a wide open world and you can literally go anywhere and do whatever you want, just the way I play games, I needed to latch onto a little bit of structure. So it was the first couple hours, as soon as anyone gave me like a story quest, it's like, that's what I'm going to do because I don't know what else to do right now.
Yeah. On the flip side, though, I found it odd that is so true with the entire game. Like, it gives you teeny tiny hints of where to go, but not really. But then as soon as you get into a divine beast, it's loaded with telling you what to do. It's like, do this now.
Every step of the way.
Yes. I was like, okay, I got it.
Yeah. But, okay, so our last viewer response is from our friend Drew Whining. I keep trying to find the perfect word to describe my time with Breath of the Wild, and the one I've finally settled upon is delightful. From its infinite charm to its not too difficult but occasionally frustrating shrines, to its scattered treasure chests, to its Korok mini puzzles, to its slight change of pace dungeons, to its beautiful landscapes, to its cooking experiments, to its scattered villages, to its quaint townspeople, to its side quest mysteries. It's all just so flippin' delightful. God, now I just want to go play Zelda. So do I. That was a perfect end point for Jeff to wrap it up, but he didn't.
No, because we didn't. All right, we
you're
didn't
the only one rating.
All right,
are we gonna have closing thoughts or anything?
Well, like I, was,
Yeah, sure. I was going to just say, like, I rated the fun factor for me. Like, everything else in the game, you know, I can talk, like, yeah, the sound isn't the best. For me, at least it wasn't. The control had major hits. The story is neither here nor there. Like, I didn't feel like the story was actually all that good.
No, the story's buried in the memories, too.
Yeah, I don't know what the story is, but the voice acting's so terrible, and I feel like it's actually pretty one note in terms of, I don't know. I don't buy the, I don't know which guy wrote it, but that there's, like, pain of, like, longing and that kind of stuff. Like, it's not hitting home for me. So I don't feel like the story was all that good. But it doesn't do anything to undermine the idea that the fun factor is a perfect score for me.
It's a 5 out of 5 for me. Yeah. Even when I've been frustrated, it's like, I don't want to stop playing this.
Yeah.
Having the time of my life with this game.
Like, I have no desire to, like, play it nonstop because I don't want it really to end.
Yeah. Even though we sort of have been playing it nonstop, and the end is nowhere near in sight.
Yeah, that's true.
Except for Pete. I'm sorry. I wish Pete loved it more.
And that's probably my closing thing, is that I'm genuinely jealous of you guys, because I wish I did like it more. I do not have fun playing this game for some reason, and I actually fell asleep one time.
Well, you're playing in your bed too.
True. But I'm sorry, guys. Failed you.
No, you didn't. You say, like, a long time ago that you weren't gonna like it. I was braced for you to hate it. And
I did say a long time ago that I didn't think it was a Zelda game, and I stand by that.
Maybe not, but I sure do like what we got. And I haven't played a Zelda game that I genuinely like this much since Ocarina and Majora's Mask. And I guess Wind Waker. But Twilight Princess and the other one, Skyward Sword, those didn't do it for me either. Those were like sticking to the same tropes that a Zelda game should have, but not doing anything interesting.
Yeah,
and
I agree with that.
This one is like, okay, those games haven't been great. What can we do to make it new and cool again?
Mm-hmm. I feel like it's the next leap forward for the franchise, where you had Link to the Past, and it took a huge jump forward into Ocarina of Time. Like, that kind of leap was so huge.
Yeah,
that this feels like feels like a big leap for the franchise.
Yeah, makes me very interested about the new Mario too.
Worried, but excited.
Yeah,
I just don't like the idea that Mario's in our world.
It's only cautiously one of the levels. Optimistic is how I describe myself.
Yeah, it's definitely a have to buy, but I don't expect to enjoy it.
Wow, I'm like, at this point, Nintendo's first party games, if they're at all like thinking the way that they were for Zelda, there's gonna be a solid 10 out of 10s for me.
Are you guys getting the new Mario Kart?
Oh, fuck yeah, man.
Can we play somehow?
Probably.
Yep. Yeah, we'll fucking see.
At work.
That'd be during actually
the
cool.
Day. That'd be awesome.
I could jump in. Cool. That would be fucking awesome.
The one thing, though, that Nintendo doesn't have is, like, party chat. You have to do it through your app, right?
Yeah, and that app doesn't even exist yet.
Yeah, so, great.
Yeah, there's a lot of issues with the Switch itself at this point, I'd say, but Zelda is...
Yeah, it's all very arcane.
It's the best.
But, so to wrap it up, overall score for me was a 4.5, which is a full point higher than any other game we've talked about this year. So
from you.
Yeah, from me, yeah.
Okay.
So right now it's my leading game of the year.
I'm
excited about that.
To that too.
What should we do next, guys?
Did you guys actually settle on a game for April?
We did not.
I actually thought that maybe we should look at Blaster Master Zero.
Oh.
Is that only on Steam though?
No, it's on the Switch, dude.
It's on the Switch.
Is it?
Yeah.
Is it out?
Yeah.
It's out?
Yeah.